school. This is the fourth year that I've been here, and this is, I'm so excited. This is our very first symphonic band winter concert. The band in front of you consists of mostly eighth graders and some seventh graders. And about two years ago, I kind of contrived this whole notion of, let's have a symphonic and a concert band. The high school does it. Let's see if we can make it work for middle school, because what I was finding is we always have a group of seventh graders that are really advanced, and they're doing really well. They're really hard workers, and they're the type of people who really need to be with the eighth graders because they're ready to play that type of music. They're ready to be pushed. And then the eighth graders, in the same regard, they needed to be surrounded by more people who are at that level to kind of push them as well. So we're really excited to have this, and it's been the first year I've ever done it. It's been a big change for me, and it's a different change for them, but I'm super excited about what's happening on a day-to-day basis with them. So, first off, they've had a really busy year. You guys have noticed they've done a lot of events and things like that, but right now we're kicking it back into an actual concert band, and this is our first performance for you, and we're going to start out with a very difficult song called Celtic Carol by Robert W. Smith. Olivia Bybrook. really fun piece to play. Okay, so we're going to feature our percussion section next, and they're going to play a song called Robin Laid an Egg. Sometimes it sounds like a sour egg. It's supposed to, okay? And then this is also going to be conducted by Miss Brown, and I'm so lucky enough to have Miss Brown come in for the symphonic band. She's been pulling kids out. We've been working on this percussion ensemble. She's been pulling out the woodwinds to work on that crazy Celtic carol because their parts are crazy. So without further ado, Miss Brown. While the percussion's getting reset back up for the next song, I do want to mention a couple things. First off, if you haven't started following us on social media, talking about Instagram and Facebook, please do. We also have a Remind group, and I think there was probably a slide earlier about the Remind group. If you don't know what to do, you can text the @ KMS Band SYM for Symphonic, First Legis of Symphonic, to the number 81010. If you're not part of that Remind group, that's how we kind of keep in touch if we're going on a big trip. And these guys are all going on a big trip on Saturday. On Saturday, I told them early on at the beginning, I said, well, you guys are kind of not really a regular band. You're more like an advanced band. Like, this is an advanced class, even though it's not really labeled that way. And I said, part of that is the requirement to do all region. They have to audition for all region. So they may have been at home practicing, complaining about it, crying about it, things like that. You know, it's really fun. But I related to them. Some of them have no idea what it's like, and it's a really good experience, but it's just really hard to make it in there. We have so much competition because we're competing against schools that are like in Bentonville, all the way over to Mountain Home, and Gentry and Gravett and Harrison. I mean, there's a ton of different schools that we're competing against. And on Saturday, they're going to go and compete against about 1,000 other students for a limited, maybe 100 to 300 spots in two different bands. It's very, very difficult to make it. But if they are able to make it and put in enough work, then it's really, really rewarding. So that's what they're doing on Saturday, in case you didn't know, FYI. And then also, this band is going to be transitioning after this semester to be working on a concert competition. And if you don't know what that looks like, they have to prepare three songs, kind of like we're playing tonight, but they're not holiday songs. They have to prepare three songs, play in front of judges, they get a rating, and then they also have to sight read an entire piece of music. They have 6 minutes to look at it, they're not allowed to play their instrument, and then we have to play in front of a judge and hope that it's good. It's a very tough competition. These guys are, they're doing some incredible stuff. So I'm very proud of them. It's going to be a fun semester, and we have the Branson trip, which we're super excited about. But our next song is called "It Came Upon a Midnight Clear" by Jesse Manson.
Thank you.
First off, I want to thank our administrators and our teachers for coming out for their support and sacrificing, I guess, a Wednesday night to be here. I also want to thank you guys, your parents, for coming out here. I know it's a Wednesday. I didn't want to plan a concert on a Wednesday, but thank you so much for making arrangements around church to be here and all that stuff. It was about the only time and the only date that the auditorium was available. I'd rather you guys not sit on bleachers and listen to a band in the gymnasium when we can have this, which is much way better. So thank you. Lastly, I do want to thank you guys as parents for raising such great kids. I mean, every single day coming in here working with these guys, I haven't had a bad day at all. It's amazing to work with such amazing young people and see them grow as musicians and have the chance to see them grow up. Because I feel so blessed. Some of these kids, I've been teaching them for 3 years now, and they're going to continue on with the high school band. And I'll be with them for like 7 years total, which is amazing. That's incredible. And I hit to be a regular teacher where I only get to see him for a year. Okay, bye. I'll to the next crew. So thank you guys so much for such amazing kids. And I feel blessed every day with my job. We are going to close our concert with their probably favorite piece, which is called The Polar Express.